Alright, so boom, check me out, bro. This is gonna be a short one, but we're talking about Plague's Tale Requiem. Yeah, I mean, yeah, exactly. Correct pronunciation. But now we're talking about it because it popped up in Gamescom, and I kind of forgot about it, bro. I keep on forgetting this game is so good, but then I remember it's an L-Box exclusive, so you already know the deal, you know what I'm saying? I can't even touch it, bro. They yoink all the good ones, you know what I'm saying? But listen, I'm pretty sure this is a new game, Requiem. I don't know if that means sequel or prequel. It probably doesn't mean either. It's probably just the next game in the line. The developers were talking about it, and it was like older version of them and how they're going through it. It's gonna be less stealth, more choose your own style type of game. Cause you know, stealth is I like watching people play stealthy, but I can't do stealth. I ain't gonna lie. I ain't gonna say, because I hate stealth missions and cyberpunk, like, bro, you know, the forced stealth missions, like, you have to do it stealthy, but at some point, you don't got that many missions like that, but overall, people will most likely run and gun rather than stealth. I think stealth is one of those really niche, categories, like, you already got, like, if it's an adventure world, like, I'm pretty sure that it'll be adventure for this one, and then stealth, but, well, for the older Plague, it'll be that way for the older Plague, but this newer Plague, you'll be able to do, like, run and gun, you get, like, full-on weapons and crossbows, like, you know the deal, like, come on, stop playing, but check me out, bro, for some reason, this game has always been, like, at the back of my mind, and I don't know why. I think it's just a unique concept. I think since ever seen that trade, it's like the Guardian. Like, you know, the Guardian with the fucking big ass cat slash monkey thing, like tiger, like Colossal. Was it Colossal? No, it's something else. When you get the horse and you fight the giants of the Colossus. Yeah, that game. For those games all are in a group, and it sits at the back of my mind for being like cool games to watch. But never play, you know? Like, I don't have a urge to play it, but I love seeing the trailers. I love seeing people play it. Like, one time I put on an hour gameplay of the whole game. Like, you know how they be posting they be posting, like, story games. Like, it's more popular with story games. That they play through the whole story games, no dialogue. It's like a movie, kind of, you know what I'm saying? I've done that, like, twice for Plague, you know? And I don't do that much often, because usually I'm just watching, but having that, like, as, like, to just look at is, like, wow, this is a good game. But I am excited. I am glad that it's still going, even though I can't play it because you already know the deal. But I am glad to see that it's, like, still continuing, because I feel like this game is, like, very, like I said, it's in that group of, like, games that you, like, it will never be, like, you'll never be, like, wow, that's not a good game. Like, you know, unless they mess this one up completely, but I doubt it, you know. Plague was a pretty good game, and a lot of people were turned off by it because of the forced stealth. But Assassin's Creed kind of had forced stealth, and then to change it up here and there. I'm not an Assassin's Creed expert, so calm down, relax. I'm just saying that speaking from, like, the two games I played, you know. But maybe having a more varied approach to going into a problem or situation, it will drive the fans or people that wanted to get into this game but didn't like stealth to play it. Because even though it's an L-Box exclusive, I do want to see it kind of blow up. It just brings a little smile to my face to see Plague Cell just reach the heights of their height. I don't know why. It's just, like, I honestly don't know why. I don't know the story back in my hand. Like, it just seems like a good topic. It seems like a good story, and it seems like an interesting story, stuff like that. So, it's just like one of those games, bro. Like, you don't know what you like about it, but you just want to see it, like, prosper, you know? Even if you can never play it. Because I probably won't play it if it was available on Play, but that's not to say I don't want it to be successful. I don't know. Bro, that's the only reason I'm talking about this game. Because that weird feeling only happens with a select few games, you know? Like, it's not like TF2, because I want to play TF2. I love playing TF2. TF2 is like, it's a classic. You can't say it's not. But TF2 is in a different category than I would put Plague in the other games. Just because it's just how, I guess, unique and diverse and how, like, you have to play like this, you know? You have to play stealthy, and in Shadow of Colossus, you have to play aggressive and really learn the giant's moves and how to beat it and stuff like that. So it's like, that it's just a good game, you know what I mean? I hope it comes out better than it looks, you know what I'm saying? It just, you know, I'm rambling at this point, but check me out, bro. If you got an L-Box, you know, I ain't dissing you. I'm just saying, you might want to pick it up. It might be a little side game you might like, all right? That's all about it. That's all I got to say. I ain't gonna lie. So it's a royal outro.